Hello, clever people. So, you want to know what HTTP is? In the next 8 minutes, you'll find out what drives the whole internet. I noted down 5 points you need to know about HTTP. What it means, the client-server model, the request, the response, and the foundation on which HTTP is based, so the layers beneath it. First, let's start with the meaning. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. Now, it sounds fancy, but it's actually simple. The hyper part means that in this fancy text, you can have tables, images, and most importantly, links to other hypertext. Protocol is a more technical term for rules. This means you can translate HTTP to rules for transferring fancy text. 2. The client-server model. I'm sure you've been to a restaurant and ordered some food before. Usually, a waiter picks up your order and brings it to the kitchen. The kitchen preps your meal and the waiter brings it back to you. This interaction follows the request-response model. You request something from the menu and they bring you back the food as a response. HTTP works in a similar manner. Let's say you're on your computer or phone and you browse the internet. Each time you click on a link or visit a website, the browser creates an HTTP request. The request is sent to another computer on the internet, which is called a server. This can be, you know, Wikipedia, YouTube, Facebook, whatever you want. The server receives that request and prepares a response. It then sends it back to your browser, which in turn displays the response in a nice human-friendly web page. Your browser, in this situation, is called a client. So from a different perspective, this type of interaction is also called a client-server model. Continuing to our third item, the HTTP request. Imagine you're on Wikipedia and you click on an article about the English language. A request is sent through to the internet. Let's take a peek inside and see what's in it. First, there's a start line. It contains 3 pieces of information: the method, the path, and the version. Let's start with the request method, which is also known as the HTTP verb. In our case, it's get, because we are getting the Wikipedia article. Get is used anytime you want to read some data, like opening up a website or refreshing your Twitter feed. There are verbs for each type of action you can do as a client. For example, post is used to write data, like posting a tweet to Twitter or liking a page on Facebook. There are verbs for updating data, like put, which is used for full updates, and patch, which is used for partial updates. And then there's also a verb for deleting data. I'll give you a second to guess its name. If you said delete, you won the $1 million prize. Good going. In the second part of the start line, it's the path. It points to the requested resource. In our case, it's /wiki/English language. By adding this to the hostname, wikipedias.com, you obtain the full URL. Now, the last part of the start line is the version of the protocol. In our case, it's 1.1, so HTTP 1.1. Then we have the header. This is a list of small text pairs. A very common HTTP header is the content type, for example. When you send a human-readable text to the server, the content type should be text/plain. But when you upload an image, it's going to be image/JPEG. This way, the server will understand the request you are sending. A good thing to remember here is the headers can be customized depending on the need. So you can find different type of headers on different type of applications. The last part of an HTTP request is the body. It's optional, but it's based on the request type. You don't need a body for GET requests, for example, but you do need one for POST requests. Now, did you learn anything? If you think this video is helpful, take a second and use that like button below. It helps a lot. Fourth item on our list, the response. You need to send a request before you can receive a response. Let's see what Wikipedia sent us back as a response to our previous request. The structure is fairly similar, but its contents differ. Again, there are 3 elements on the start line. The first element is the protocol version, which is the same as we can find in the request. Then it has a status code and the reason. In our case, because the response was successful, we have the code 200 and the message OK. All codes that start with the 2 are success codes. On the other hand, if the resource you were searching for isn't there anymore, you may receive a 404 not found. All codes that start with a 4 represent a client error, while codes that start with a 5 are server errors. If you want to find more about HTTP codes, I've put a list of them in the description below. Next, we have the headers. There's no major difference here, so we won't get into the details. The last section of the response is the body. This is where the server puts the actual response content. In our case, it contains the actual wiki page about the English language. Remember, a response body is not mandatory. For example, while you're editing an online document, like a wiki page, the website would save your progress from time to time. The verb for this save would be patch, and an usual response would have a status of 204, and the reason no content, so you don't really need a body for it. Cool. Let's get on to our last point, 5, the layers beneath HTTP. For this, we need to take a step back and take a deeper look at how the internet works. If we were to slice the whole internet into layers, HTTP would be the application layer, which is on top. Beneath, we have the transport layer. Looking back to our restaurant example, the transport layer would be the waiter. When he takes your request, you don't really care how he does it, but you rely on him to send your message to the kitchen. Same goes for the kitchen, which is responsible to prep your meal, but it relies on the waiter to transport it back to you. The transport layer has its own protocols, one of them being TCP. And the rabbit hole goes even deeper. There's another layer beneath, which is the physical one. If you want to go more in depth on how they sliced up the internet, check the article in the description below. Now, here's a short bonus tip. If you want this information to stick, I encourage you to inspect the request and the response as they happen in your own browser. Yes, you can do that. It works on all modern browsers, Windows, Mac, or Linux. So, open up Chrome. Go to wikipedia.org. Go to the English section. And this is the article we've been talking about, the English language. Now, before we access it, we need to open up developer tools. For this, in Chrome, we have multiple ways. One of them being going to these three dots here, more tools, developer tools. Another shortcut for this is to just use F12. F12 also works in Firefox, in Microsoft Edge. For Safari, you need to enable an option before you can actually open up developer tools. I'll use F12 for this example. We need to go to the networking tab. And this means that Chrome will record any interaction between our browser and the internet. So let's click on the English language. Now, there are a lot of things being loaded here, all of them spawning down from this first document. If we click it, we can see the information that Chrome has decided is important for most of the users. So it's not exactly the representation we've used in the examples before. They mix up data from the request and the response in the general tab. We can see here the request URL, which is comprised of the host, wikipedia.org, and the path from the request start line. Then we see the request method, which is also on the request start line. Then we see the status code, which is on the response start line, and some additional information here. If we go to the response header section, we will find, for example, the content type, which is one of the headers we've talked about. Then if we go to response, for example, we will see the whole HTML being displayed nicely by our browser here. Great. Thanks for sticking to the end. For further reading about HTTP, I would recommend Mozilla Foundation's article, An Overview of HTTP. As always, you can find the link in the description below. You'll also find there a downloadable version of the sketch. Maybe, you know, use it as a cheat sheet or a quick reference when you need to remember what was in this video. If you have questions or would like to see content on a specific topic, leave a comment below. I'll be happy to answer. Cheers and have a good one.